And joining us now for more is Harvard astrophysicist Dr. Avi Loeb. It's great to have you back, Dr. Loeb. So at this point, there's worldwide interest in this thing, and NASA still hasn't released the photos. How is that possible?
Well, either NASA is not functional, or there is a reason for that. And it's really unfortunate because that should have been the sharpest image we've got of this object with a pixel resolution of 30 kilometers. It was taken on October 2nd, 2025. And here we are, haven't seen it yet. The best picture we have so far is from the Hubble Space Telescope, three times worse in resolution. And what we noticed from the Hubble Space Telescope is there is a glow extending from the object towards the sun. This was confirmed in an image that was released just yesterday from a ground-based telescope. And it's very puzzling because this extension of the object towards the sun is 10 times longer than it is wide.
It's not like nobody is working at NASA because the government has been shut down for the past couple of weeks. So I don't buy it. Do you think it's suspicious that NASA hasn't made an effort to put these photos out there?
It's strange because the principal investigator of this camera called HiRISE on board the Mars Reconnaissance Orbiter is not affiliated with NASA. He is at the University of Arizona. And obviously, they can still analyze the data and release it scientifically. Right. There is no need for a press release. The European Space Agency already released their data, which was much worse quality, because, you know, that's the way things are in science. You make the data available to other scientists so they can look into it.
Okay, so ESA, what you're saying, ESA, the European Space Agency, they released the images that we're now showing you. But NASA has not, and NASA's got their hands on the best imagery of whatever this thing is. So, Dr. Loeb, you get the conspiracy theory that's now developing. If this thing is a comet, maybe NASA, or if this thing is an alien spacecraft, maybe NASA is deliberately covering that up by not releasing those photos. You see that, right?
Well, that's one possibility. It's also possible they're not competent or they don't want to do the work while they are in shutdown. I'm not sure what the actual reason is, but, you know, we should be guided by data, and I very much look forward to them releasing it so we can analyze it, because the previous data was already very anomalous. There are 8 anomalies of this object that we cannot fully understand. And, you know, if it happens not to be a comet, but something else, we should know about it. The White House should know about it.
Yeah, we should all know about it. Has the White House been briefed, to your knowledge?
Not that I know of, but I did brief Congress people, and I really hope that President Trump knows everything there is to know about this object.
And just quickly, if it does swing around the sun and starts heading toward Earth, that will confirm that this is intelligent life and intelligently controlled. What do we do then?
We don't have a protocol, and there should be some kind of an organization that looks into interstellar objects of this type, because, you know, it's a threat to the future of humanity. It could be a black swan event with a low probability but huge implications. And so far, such a threat was not attended to, politically speaking. And I do believe that we should examine all the facts and decide without any assumptions about the nature of this object.
Yeah, and this thing could land on Earth in early 2026. Is that accurate, if it wanted to?
It could, yeah. It could do a maneuver when it's closest to the sun. It could release probes that will visit us. And it's just like some visitor in our backyard that could enter through the front door, and you want to figure out what the intent is. And it's just a matter of curiosity, but also concern about the future of humanity. So I really hope that we will change the way we deal with such interstellar objects in the future.
All right, Dr. Avi Loeb, thanks so much for coming back. We appreciate it. Have a great weekend. Thank you.
Thanks for having me.